Mr. Dennis Skinner.
I'm not so sure I thought at the time it'd be a good idea for me to say anything, because as sure as night followed day, I'd not been here very long. And I actually proclaimed, having been a miner for 20-odd years, I said, when I went down the pit and somebody died, I said, what happened was that four people took him out on a trolley along the rails, and they were allowed to go home, and the rest of the pit continued to work, because people like us had managed to secure a tiny agreement with the coal board to get £250 for the miners' winger. And on that basis, the rest of us went to work. Now, what I'm trying to convey is, just like then as now, for the people out there that are having to suffer the austerity and the benefit cuts and the increasing costs for their own funeral, they're the people that concern me, just like in those days of 1975, it was the miners that had left behind to speak for them in Parliament. Talking about the thing that we sometimes suggest has gone away. Class. That's what it is. It's about class. And it's about the fact that people out there have to live their lives in a different way. And there's one rule for those at the top, and there's another for those at the bottom. It's never changed. I wish it had, but it hasn't. What's it all about? we hear, we should remember where we come from. And I remember those people. I remember my own family. 9 kids, haven't got to 8, Mr. Rudd, together. It's still embedded in my soul. And that's why I speak as I do. And I don't want to change. I never will. It won't get my hands on the dispatch box. But that's not a luxury that's ever bothered me. It's important to remember that these words of mine don't come out of my mouth because of envy, because of greed. It's because I believe that we have to look after those people that haven't got to eat, Mr. Rudd, together. That should be what motivates us.
Thank you. We meet at a college noted for knowledge, in a city noted for progress, in a state noted for strength, and we stand in need of all three. For we meet in an hour of change and challenge, in a decade of hope and fear, in an age of both knowledge and ignorance. The greater our knowledge increases, George Mallory, who was to die on Mount Everest, was asked why did he want to climb it. He said, because it is there. Well, space is there, and we're going to climb it. And the moon and the planets are there, and new hopes for knowledge and peace are there. And therefore, as we set sail, we ask God's blessing on the most hazardous and dangerous and greatest adventure on which man has ever embarked. Thank you.
So it's not as if this thing hasn't happened before. And I actually proclaimed, having been a miner for 20-odd years, I said, when I worked down the pit and somebody died, I said, what happened was that four people took him out on a trolley along the rails, and they were allowed to go home, and the rest of the pit continued to work because people like us had managed to secure a tiny agreement with the coal board to get £250 for the miners' winger. And on that basis, the rest of us went to work. Now, what I'm trying to convey is, just like then as now, for the people out there that are having to suffer the austerity and the benefit cuts and the increasing costs for their own funeral. They're the people that concern me, just like in those days of 1975. It was the miners that had left behind to speak for them in Parliament. We're here talking about the thing that we sometimes suggest has gone away. Class. That's what it is. It's about class. And it's about the fact that people out there have to live their lives in a different way. And there's one rule for those at the top, and there's another for those at the bottom. It's never changed. I wish it had, but it hasn't. I know that there is within a lot of us the desire to fight at the edges.